Sustainability is so much more than just environmental science. It's also about social justice, and economics, and design.
One example that comes to mind for me is housing equity and affordable housing. These are very important things with regards to developing sustainable cities and communities. What's exciting is that these examples fit perfectly into an existing framework that connects us to a broader global community. And that framework is the UN's Sustainable Development Goals.
With the new Meridian High School coming online last year, that afforded so many new opportunities for us to be able to expand upon the many sustainable related projects that are already taking place within the schools district-wide. We realize that every one of us in our division is involved with sustainability each and every day, whether we know it or not.
We asked some of our colleagues to share with us how sustainability is woven into the work that they do.
So I'd like to talk to you about sustainability in the art class. These are some examples of coil-built pottery done by students here at Meridian. And it's based on a lesson where we have studied a man named Juan Cazedo Salado, who's a Mexican potter who lives in a small rural town known as Mata Ortiz in the Chihuahua section of Mexico. He actually discovered ancient pottery from the Mimbres and Casa Grandes tribes in his local area. And through his study, he found the techniques that they use, coil-built pottery, and also the design elements that they used, and revived this style of pottery and began to make it himself. He didn't find a market in Mexico per se, in his local area, but he did find a market in the US, and then it became known worldwide to the point that now there's over 300 families in Mexico that earn all or part of their living through the production of Mata Ortiz pottery, which is known worldwide.
The sustainability initiative, as articulated for Falls Church City Public Schools, is something that ties in really well to what we're doing at Meridian in the English department, particularly in the 11th and 12th grade English courses. IB asks students to trace a global issue through the text that they study throughout their junior year. For example, last year, one student looked at how the novel, The Joy Luck Club, and short stories by Russian author Anton Chekhov illustrated that oppressive gender stereotypes often discourage female authenticity.
Here at Jesse Thackeray Preschool, we welcome students ages 2 through 4. Our team works with students and their families to make sure that their first experience in our school division is awesome. Our team is committed to closing gaps so all of our students enter kindergarten ready for success.
In history class, sustainability shows up in all of the events, politics, economics, and environmental issues that we study. Especially when it comes to social injustices and inequities. I ask my kids to look at things from different perspectives and to see how these events have shaped the world that we live in today and how would they rewrite history to make the world a better place. For instance, I ask them to debate and draft new constitutions for post-Civil War that offer the best chance of long-lasting peace. Another one is in the Great Plains and westward expansion. How would you do equitable land usage between Native Americans, farmers, coal miners, railroads, and even cowboys? It helps them to understand that their generation is going to be the ones to fix things. And these UN sustainability goals are really the first step.
While teaching in second grade, I became a National Geographic certified educator so that I could connect my students with Nat Geo scientists from all over the world and with different teachers all over the world through the scientists. One is EPALS, where we connected with second grade students in India. We learned about plants and animals within their country and with our country, and the students got to communicate their wonder and their excitement and their learner agency, their skill sets. Having that wonder and excitement and reflection really builds that belief that I can make a change. This is exciting. Action is exciting. We are all lifelong learners, and it is a goal of mine, and I know FCCPS, to provide the foundation that all students believe they are lifelong learners too.
So there are various ways that I see sustainability show up in our building, specifically in my classroom with fourth graders. I have my students really look at water and the process of cleaning and purifying water. And we go through a water purification or water filter challenge where students have to design and engineer a water filter, and we test it to clean dirty water. This is great for students because they're not only becoming thinkers, but they're really exploring and understanding how they can connect with their community and clean their planet.
When we celebrate the Hispanic Heritage Month in Spanish, students have the opportunity to research Hispanic heritage people who have made great contributions to the American society. In the beginning, students always think of female singers and male baseball players. But once they start doing their research, they quickly realize that there are famous and important people in business, scientists, judges, politicians, and they are all from both genders, and they all have made great contributions to the American society. With this project, students can think of a future without gender roles and stereotypes.
The Family Resource Center serves more than 50 families. We help them by building their lives in Falls Church, helping with registration, making sure they have school supplies and winter coats. We offer parent workshops, adult English classes, and other community resources. When new families arrive, we reach out to them right away and include them in the community.
So in transportation, sustainability involves reducing the number of vehicles on the road in order to reduce the amount of greenhouse emissions that's all over the U.S. The latest push is electric vehicle usage. FCCPS is excited to announce that we have submitted an application for the grant and funding of 2 electric school buses. Hopefully this time next year, we'll have 2 electric school buses that we'll put into operational use to transport some of our students.
Thanks so much for sharing your practice. Now that we've seen these examples, we invite you to consider the ways that sustainability shows up in the work that you do every day.